Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to create and configure the Syncfusion Angular ComboBox component using the Angular CLI tool and Syncfusion EJ2 Angular dropdowns package. I will also show you how to configure a few of this component's basic features, like data binding, autofill data, and pop-up customization. The Angular ComboBox component is a dropdown list with an editable text box that also allows users to choose an option from a predefined pop-up list. We can also add custom values in the ComboBox pop-up list, which I'll demonstrate in my next video. Let's start with the application creation process. First, I create my app using the Angular CLI command. I'm using VS Code as the editor and showing the output in the Chrome browser. In the command prompt, I install the CLI tool globally using the npm install global Angular CLI command. Then, I create a new Angular project using the ng new command and provide the app name, my Angular project. I navigate to the desired location and install the ComboBox package using the ng add Syncfusion EJ2 Angular dropdowns command. Now, I open the project in VS Code. To start using the ComboBox component, I navigate to the App Module page and import the ComboBox module from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular dropdowns package. I register it in the imports array of the ng module. After that, I import the material theme styles to the style.css file to apply styles to the ComboBox component. Next, I need to register the Syncfusion license key. I open the main TypeScript file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the Angular trial license. Starting with the 2022 Volume 1 release, the license key is mandatory for Angular projects to avoid a licensing warning. In the app.component.html file, I replace the default code snippets with the Angular ComboBox component using the EJS ComboBox tag. To provide a hint of the expected value, I set the placeholder property to select a game. Let me run this application using the command ng serve. See, the ComboBox is rendered with the hint. And ComboBox dropdown displays no records found. Let's see how to bind data to the ComboBox. In the app component class, I declare the variable sports data and assign an array of string values such as cricket, football, tennis, and so on. In the app component.html page, I assign that sports data to the datasource property of the ComboBox component. I also need to map the text and value fields while binding the data. For an array of simple data, both text and value fields will be considered the same, so field mapping is not required. See, I can select any sport from the dropdown list. I can also bind a JSON array to the ComboBox. In the app component class, I define a JSON object, naming it sports data. Then I define the object values with two fields, ID and game. I will assign this JSON object to the datasource property. Then I need to map the JSON object fields to the value and text fields using the fields property. In the app component class, I declare the variable field settings and map ID field to the value property and game field to the text property. Then assign this variable to the fields property. And now, the ComboBox dropdown list displays JSON data. I can also bind arrays of complex data. Look at the complex data, it has the fields country and code. Each field has its own object. In the field settings, the code.id column needs to be mapped to the value property and the country.name field mapped to the text property. Then, I assign this complex data to the datasource property. Also change the placeholder based on the complex data. Checking now, the ComboBox list displays the complex data. To bind remote data, I use the Syncfusion Data Manager. In the App Component class, I import the Data Manager from the namespace EJ2Data. Then, I declare the variable remote data and create an instance of the Data Manager to provide the service endpoint URL using the URL property. I assign the remote data link. Let's have a look at the remote data. It has fields like employee ID, first name, and so on. In the field settings, I map the employee ID to the value property and the first name field to the text property. To make the server understand the request and process the response, we need to specify the adapter type. You can refer to the different adapter types in the UG link provided in the description below. Here, I use the Web API adapter and enable the cross-domain option. I assign this variable to the DataSource property. In the App Component class, I declare another variable, Query, and create an instance of Query to specify the field name to fetch from the remote data. I assign this to the Query property in ComboBox. Then change the placeholder value. Check now on the ComboBox list shows remote data. So far, we have seen how to bind local and remote data to the ComboBox. You can also add custom values dynamically, which you will also see in my next video. Next, let's see how to configure the height and width of the ComboBox pop-up list. By default, the width of the pop-up list automatically adjusts to the ComboBox input element's width, and the height of the pop-up list is 300 pixels. To customize it, I add pop-up height property and set its value to 250 pixels, and then add pop-up width with a value of 300 pixels. Checking now, the pop-up is customized based on the provided height and width. Finally, to enable the autofill support in the ComboBox input element, I just enable the autofill property. Now, whenever I start typing a word, the ComboBox will auto-complete your data by matching the typed character. In this video tutorial, I showed you how to create and configure the Syncfusion Angular ComboBox component using the Angular CLI tool and Syncfusion EJ2 Angular dropdowns package and few of its basic features. You can download the working example used in this video from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.